During the operation, a total of 7 suspects were arrested in connection with illegal possession and sale of government drugs and medical equipment. Among the arrested is Yusuf Katuramu, a police officer attached to Chenjojo District, Samuel Mwesige, the in-charge of Weramuli Health Center in Intoroko District, and Mary Mbabazi, an enrolled nurse at Weramuli. The other suspects are Dennis Blessing, Isaiah Isingoma, Tom Bwambale, and Alex Mbusa.
Some drugs are labeled by government of Uganda for public use only, and some of them are selling expiries.
According to Abias Ramwiri, the National Drug Authority spokesperson, several government drug supplies that included over 100 tins of ARVs, 80 tons of malaria testing strips, 100 boxes of HIV testing strips, 12 jerrycans of laboratory reagents, unpacked antibiotics and paracetamol, among others, were discovered.
From where I'm in the center, three, a porter, as I indicated, was found at his home possessing several boxes of government of Uganda drugs, and he confessed that working with his enablers, were selling some of these drugs to the brokers that take them to Congo.
Ramwiri also explained that the theft of government drugs has long-lasting consequences on the country's healthcare system. Preliminary investigations also indicate that some of the stolen government medicines were being illegally sold to the Democratic Republic of Congo. All the recovered drugs are being treated as court exhibits.
Malaria test kits, HIV test kits, hepatitis test kits, and all these were being kept in unfavorable condition. Drugs are very sensitive products that must be kept in regulated temperatures, and therefore we cannot guarantee the safety and the efficacy of these products that we have recovered.
Vincent Twesiji, the Rwenzori Regional Police spokesperson, confirmed that all the arrested suspects are being held at the Fort Portal Central Police Station pending prosecution in courts of law.
And we've arranged their file today. It has gone to court to state for legal advice, and we've preferably have 5 charges. We have that one, operating without a license. We have illegal possession of government stores. These are government stores.
According to Twesiji, many more suspects will be arrested as investigations into the case are still ongoing.
We also prefer another charge called abuse of office. That is, abuse of office needs, you might find they have been conniving. You've seen a porter having medicine from the stores with the dispatch book being written that what we have, the little evidence we have, it is clearly leaving the hospital, but it doesn't go to the destination. So also we've also had that case of abuse of office.
Report compiled by Rogers Sunday for the news.